Rustam Kasimjanov with us. The game finished in favor of Alexander. So let's check what happened.
Yes, okay. It was one of the most tense games in my life. Okay, it was very interesting from the beginning. I noticed very few people know that by this move order, black also gets notable. I mean, at least if white plays knight f3. I actually didn't know it for 30 years, but then I learned it. Okay, so we went to transpose to notable, which is one of the most exciting systems existing in chess. But the problem is, okay, I think for both of us we had very limited knowledge, because I think knight e4 is played many times, but what to do next, I have no idea. C5. I thought bishop c6 is logical, although maybe it made sense to play bishop d5 instead. I don't know. Okay, so I played this, and here Rustam tricked me. He played queen c2, f5, bishop c4. And I thought his idea was just to attack next move with queen b3. So I played queen e7. The point is that now queen b3 is quite bad, because king h8, take, 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 queen c4, and I take here, and I'm left with an extra pawn. But instead, Rustam played bishop b3, which is a very strong move, and now it looks quite dangerous for black, because now I sort of lack ideas. I mean, there are several ideas. One is to bring some piece to g6, either queen or rook, to pin white, but now it's impossible because rook f6, d5. And another idea is try to activate the knight, but it also now doesn't work because knight e5. So yeah, so here I started just to make some moves, I mean, quite senseless moves actually. Maybe I should have played queen e8. Now with bishop b3, it's now quite a big difference, because I think first of all I can play knight f6, and if knight e5, I have a4.
Problems.
And take, complete. I think I win a piece. So, yeah, but the point is that I didn't like queen b3, and now, if I now play knight, king h8, then white take, 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 bishop g7, king g7, check, let's say king h6, king is actually quite safe for the moment, at least. Bishop c4, and I think the position is about equal. I mean, white is definitely not worse, I believe, because, okay, I mean, king is weaker, after all.
If you go queen g6?
No, okay, you just defend somehow. Mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe even like this. Because bishop e2, knight, knight d3. Yeah, so, okay, so I wanted to avoid it, and avoid it, but at a pretty high cost. So now bishop b3, I didn't know what to do, I even thought to play g5, but...
Looks like a really bad move,
huh? G5. No, I'm not sure. I mean, if I'm in time to play g4 and knight df6, it will be quite okay. Mm-hmm. But of course, yes, it's not the move I really wanted to make. So okay, I played king h8, now rook e d1, which is quite unpleasant move, because white always want to play d5. For example, if f4, I didn't like that white just plays like this, gives a pawn. But I was not sure if I'm not going to lose the piece because of some piece. But maybe it was objectively right continuation. But maybe what I did is not so bad. Okay, so I play queen e8. Now I want knight df6. Also d5 is nothing because I have my bishop protected with the queen. So bishop a4, and now it becomes quite forced. Rook a4, knight df6. Okay, so my point was that if knight e5, I can play knight g4, and the rook is handy. So white cannot take. But rook a1 is much stronger. Now knight g4, I think, is just bad because white takes, takes, takes. Knight takes with some knight. And maybe even d5, d5, take rook a7. I don't know, I actually have no attack whatsoever, and my just, I think, will win quite easily. So I had to rely on some tricks, queen b5, knight e5. Now, knight d5 is bad because of queen c4, and I lose a pawn, I think, rook b8, take, take, and knight c4, and white just wins a pawn. I believe at the game soon. So yeah, knight g4, and here it's a very critical moment because I think queen d3 was a very decent alternative. Okay, so if I take, I think I pretty much resign because I lose the pawn.
Yeah, we'll do that. Queen
d8. Okay, so I had two options. One is rook b8.
Take knight d3.
Yeah, take knight d3, but maybe I will have some drawing chances. Yeah, of course I will.
Yeah, but b4 is hanging, yeah?
I know, otherwise I would be okay.
Yeah, but also f3 is threatening.
So. No, I mean, if b4 was not hanging, I could go like this.
And then
it
takes
b4. No, but that's what I mean.
No, but I mean, I don't see any move for you, that's what I mean.
Mm, okay. Some, I don't know, 92 maybe. No, should be, lost. Okay, and other idea was queen b7. But then the problem is c6, take, and white has time to take. I mean, it's still not over because I probably play rook d8.
Yeah, this position I focus on bishop c1, yeah?
Maybe f3, no?
Maybe f3.
But knight still, knight d2, ah, yes.
No, rook d1, you take.
Yes, yes, yes. No, that's what I mean. I mean, at least with 3 minutes, it's not so clear. I mean, even now, it's not, for me, it's not. But here craziness happened because, okay, I calculated the lines and then Rustam take, I immediately took on g4 and realized I could just win a whole tempo with b3. It's just a whole tempo. So white probably has to go queen b1, only move. I take, take, and it's just the same position with the whole tempo. I mean, at the very least, I can play like h6, and it will make a huge difference in all of the lines that I have this. Как там, фортишки window? А, Luft for the king. Yeah, but I just took immediately, and immediately saw. Okay, so, queen f, but still, it's, I don't think it's, at least practically, it's not hopeless, because queen c2 looked like a good move, but then queen a2, and suddenly, these pawns, they don't go anywhere, and just king comes and I resign. So b3.
Yeah, I thought queen c4 was just killing your play.
No, but I also thought so first, but actually I have two moves here, rook a7 or rook f6. I mean, maybe computer will win easily, but...
yeah, maybe I should take queen takes g4, it just takes my time to take the pawn.
Yes. But I will just...
maybe queen c2.
Queen c2, yeah, queen d1.
Yeah, if rook f2, then white is probably winning, yeah?
Or not certainly, yeah? Mm-hmm. Because the game...
you had something similar, yeah?
But it could be much better for black.
Ah, yeah, rook a5.
No, it's always rook a5. No, that's, for example, one of the differences. If I had h6, it would be no problem for black, I believe. So, but I thought it's not over yet. I can play like... I mean, just to put the pawn to b2.
You can take with the b pawn as well, eh? Instead of with the rook. You could take with the b pawn when you did rook takes it.
But I think I will still lose.
Okay, so it's just rook for c1.
Yeah, but I don't know if queen
it's not
b4,
easy to lose because, of course, this c pawn is a bit of a
queen. Queen e2, for instance.
Yes, b2. Ah, here. Ah, yes. Because I always have queen c1 also. I mean, it's. Not super obvious, at least. Just 1 minute. And then queen c4, yeah, rook f6. Yeah, here I was quite stupid to spend like half of my time whether to play rook a7 or rook f6. But okay. Queen c1, yes, queen a2. And here actually I thought that with 25 seconds or whatever you should have just tried to repeat.
Ah, I was going to, and then
but
I...
But then maybe I can take.
Yeah, take a4. I was not sure about
yes,
it.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, I think yes, you should have just repeat, because now it becomes some craziness. There are so many tactical opportunities.
No, but yeah, I think c6 is just a blunder for many reasons.
Yes.
I started missing some moves. B2 queen c4, I missed queen takes f1, but it doesn't work. Yeah? Queen f1, rook c6.
Yeah, but yes, I actually started. But yeah, rook a2,
rook
b8.
Rook b2, h3, or g3.
I think it should be a draw.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, but I just started to play for Taekwondo. Okay, I succeeded. Queen d2, I don't know. I mean, now
but
I look at
c7 again, it's looking good for white, yes?
Yeah, but I don't. For me, it looked I should win in two moves, but no, nothing works. Queen f2, rook f2, and b1 just. Yeah.
But after rook c8, your threat is rook f2, yeah?
Yes.
So I cannot go like g3. Queen b5 doesn't help, yeah? Or does it?
Okay, let's see. So it's like in the game.
Yeah.
But then I thought I'm winning. Maybe B1?
Crazy trouble beginning.
Yes. Here I am.
Yeah, but awfully tough position to play with seconds on the clock. Yeah.
Stan, would you like to add something about this game? I mean, did you feel that it was better for you during the game, especially the moment which Alexander mentioned?
No, at some point when I played 95. I felt that the game is going very much into my direction, but of course I still have to make very precise moves. Yeah. And I missed a lot of things. For instance, knight takes g4, e3, I missed. Okay, luckily, Sasha did not play this, but I missed it nonetheless. And also, I underestimated this endgame because I thought this would be tricky but technical, yeah? And it was probably nowhere near technical in time trouble. I thought queen c4, I control everything, but this counterplay against f2, I underestimated a little bit. I was thinking about this game, Korchnoi-Spassky, where white has his pawn on c7 and black tries to mate on the back rank, but Spassky did not succeed. And
yeah, but actually in this game it was black who had a weak king.
Yes.
So it's quite a difference.
So Korchnoi succeeded and you succeeded, so basically the weak king gets mated, yeah. But okay, it's an interesting game, I think much better game than we played in Baku. More of a fight, I would say. Yeah, same result.
Okay. Okay, questions? Thank you very much.